Hi everyone, welcome to NuttX channel. Today I will show how to use GPIO on NuttX. Okay, so open the Linux terminal, enter inside NuttX space. Now we need to clone the NuttX repository and the NuttX application repository. So execute git clone https://bitbucket.org/nuttx/nuttx. Let's see, it's finished the cloning of NuttX. Okay, it's cloned the NuttX repository. Now we need to clone the applications repository. Okay, now we can enter inside NuttX, enter inside tools, execute.config.sh STM32F103 /NSH. Okay, we can return to base directory. And now we need to execute make menuconfig to select the options to get the GPIO working. First, we need to select the USB cancel. Look the previous video to know how to do that, and I will speed up the video. Okay, now we need to select the options to get the GPIO working. So go to device drivers, IO expander, GPIO support, GPIO driver. Now we need to select the GPIO example here, GPIO driver example. Okay, so that is it. Now we can save and compile it. Okay, the compilation finished. Now I need to show how to connect the relay and red switch in the STM32F103 minimum board to get the GPIO working. Okay, now I'll show how I connect the relay and read switch to the STM32F103 minimum board. So the read switch, I connect the 3.3 volts and GND to write pins, as you can see here, and the D0, the green wire, I connected to, let's see here, to A2, okay, to pin A2. The relay I connect to 5 volts and GND, and the pin CH1 I connect to A1. See here the white wire connect to A1. So basically that is it. So we connected the read switch and relay in the STM32F103 minimum board. So now we can flash the firmware inside the board. So use the OpenOCD command to flash the firmware. Okay, done, it is flashed. Now we need to unplug and plug again the USB cable of STM32F103 minimum board. When I do it, the GPIO run and the relay turns the bulb lamp on. So let's see if the ACM0 was detected. Okay, it is here. Now we can enter in minicon and change to use the ACM0. Now we can press 3 times. Okay, we get the NuttX shell. Now let's list the slash dev directory. Okay, I can see the GPIO device drive created 3 GPIO files, special files. The GPIN0, GPINT2, GPOUT1. So we can see we have the GPIO command now. Let's execute it and see the options. Okay, I want to turn off the lamp. So I will execute GPIO O0 slash dev slash GPOUT1. Okay, the lamp turned off. And if I want to turn it on again, I just write 1 to the GPOUT1. Okay, turn it on. Let's turn it off again because the light is a little bit annoying. Okay, now I will use a small magnet to test the read switch, okay? So we need to execute GPIO wait for signal number. Let's test the number 1 slash dev slash GPINT2. Okay, right, it worked. Let me show now a small application I did to toggle the lamp when I approach the magnet to read switch. So the first time I approach the magnet, it will turn on. And the second time I approach, it will turn off, and so on. So it just toggle the lamp every time the magnet approach the read switch. Okay, to use it, we need to run the lamp application. This application we can find here in video description. So we can download it and extract inside the apps example. And we select it in the menu config. Okay, so let you run it. I hope you had enjoyed this video tutorial. And if you are not subscribed to NuttX channel, please do it and invite your friends to do it as well. Okay? See you in next video. Bye bye.